Okay, hi everybody. First of all, in full disclaimer, I have no idea what my hair is doing today. This is not how I intended for it to look for my episode, but it is August and it is humid, and so this is just what it's going to be today. So what inspired me to do this episode, I was watching The Pioneer Woman, which is my favorite cooking show, and she was doing an episode about easy dorm room meals, and so it inspired me to do an episode of some of my best beauty and fashion tips for staying chic and stylish when you have limited space in your dorm room or your apartment. So first off, you're going to need a caddy, like such, to hold all of your stuff, whether you're toting everything down the hall to the bathroom or just trying to keep it organized on your dresser. This is a must-have, especially when something leaks or spills. It's at least all contained in one area, and as you can see, I still use mine today. Organization is not something you graduate from. And then next up, you're going to want a chic but comfy cover-up for like lounging in your room or walking next door to visit your neighbors. College is very social like that, so you don't necessarily always have time to get ready from when you're lounging to when a social interaction presents itself. So this is this cute little Betsy Johnson terry cloth robe. It's got a hood, it has short sleeves, and it has pockets also. I've been living in this one this summer. So if you're going to school somewhere warm, or at least for right now when it's hot out, this would totally work. You could also use it as a beach or a pool cover-up, and it's super comfy. I just snuggle up in the hood when I'm lounging on the couch, and it's really comfortable, but yet it's stylish. You know, you're not like lounging in your men's white tank top. And then I mentioned in one of my last episodes how Mary Kay has a subline that's more targeted at teens. And many of these products serve a double purpose, which is great when you're going to college because there's not a lot of room. So these are great products to keep around. This stick has an eyeshadow color on one end and then a coordinating liner color on the other. And this comes in four versatile colors. It's super easy to swipe on before class. You could toss it in your bag for a quick touch up later. And then they also have these lip and cheek sticks, and so it could be used for both, so you only have to carry one thing. One of my notes, if you're going to use a product like this, especially if it's really bright, you're going to want to keep the rest of your makeup very neutral. Just think like some cover-up on some very light eyeshadow. And I love that these products are so bright. They're packaged super bright in the white. You're going to totally be able to see these in the bottom of your clutch at the black lit frat party, you know, or what have you. And depending on where you go to school, you may be further away from a Target or the mall than you're used to. So you're going to want to keep this in mind when bringing some of your toiletries to school, because you may not be able to restock until you go home for Thanksgiving break unless you want to make a special trip. So you're going to think like really large pump lotions, more than one bottle of nail polish remover, and especially these Bath & Body Works body sprays. I don't think it's possible to even use one of these up. They last forever. Like, look at this one. This is Cucumber Melon from way back in the day when the logo still was the sun. They just last forever. They're great, and then you only have to bring one thing. And then one great website that I stumbled across that wasn't around back in the Stone Age in 09 when I went away to college is Dormify. This site has all styles of rooms with bedding, accessories, wall art that all coordinate in different styles. And I know like when I was in college, the base of my desk lamp had little dividers for office supplies. And this is like a feature that you're going to want to look for in as many of your dorm items as possible. Anything that can serve more than one purpose or has some kind of built-in storage function, those items are going to be your best friends. And for college style, it could be tempting to wear t-shirts and sweats every day just because you can. I spent 8 years in a hideous uniform and then another 4 following a dress code, so I know I went to class in like my orange U of I t-shirt and brown sweatpants and completed my look with a Bob Marley hoodie more than once. Sweats are fine, but aim for some cute ones. So they have all kinds of like loungy sweatshirts like this. You know, they have some girly details. It looks just like a sweatshirt. It feels just like a sweatshirt, but you look way better. You look like you actually tried. This one has kind of like a lace back. You're just as comfortable as you would be in regular sweatpants, and you know, you throw one of these on with your leggings, some stud earrings, add your cute tote bag. That's the perfect college style. You don't look like you just rolled out of bed. I'm going to take this time to remind you all that college is actually about school and class. I know it gets a lot of airtime for other activities and whatnot, but since we're making everything else about our college experience stylish, our school supplies might as well be chic and included in that too. Cute notebooks and folders like this. Obviously, you're going to want to put stuff in this. It's adorable. I have some other ones. I won't bore you with all of them. I pretty much only buy cute notebooks and things like that. Ooh, Alice in Wonderland. All of these cute supplies can be found at Target right next to all of the drab supplies if you're willing to look. I've also seen cute pencils and pens on Etsy that have posts from Clueless and other cult movies like that. Chances are you'll be more likely to study if your notes are written in colored pen and encased in a cute notebook. Also, many colleges will provide you with a planner, but it's going to be unisex and it's not going to be cute. So if you want to actually feel good using it, there's all kinds of cute ones. I know I've shown my Lily one before. So cute. It has like a little pocket. You could stuff your schedule in there. Don't be caught looking at it, looking for what room you're going to. But they have really cute ones at any office supply store. If you want to splurge, you know, the Lily ones or Kate Spade have really pretty ones too. And a lot of them take the school year into account. And so like this one started in August from last year and it goes all the way through the next year because they want to cash in on the back to school crowd. And finally, I'm going to cover some other essentials worth mentioning. So first of all, is coloring supplies, and you're going to laugh so hard at me, but this is true. My friend's mom sent me off to college with crayons as part of my care package, and my new roommates and I spent the first afternoon coloring big signs on that big art paper for our bedroom doors. And with all the new adult coloring books that are popular these days, you should have no trouble finding one. You will get stressed out in college, that's a fact, and coloring is one really simple thing that you could do to clear your mind. And then another one is earplugs. For some of you, this may be the first time you're sharing a space with others who may have very different schedules from yours. They might be rocking out when you need to hunker down and read more chapters than you would like. So invest in earplugs. Silence is far better than cranking instrumental music, trying to drown theirs out, and you're both just going to end up frustrated. And many brands make earplugs that are for women that are smaller and they're more comfortable to wear. Get some. You'll thank me. And then I mentioned these Mary Kay facial cleansing wipes in my vacation episode, and they work just as well here, especially if your bathroom is down the hall. You can just simply moisten these with whatever water you have in a glass in your room and wash your face without needing running water in a washcloth. This is like a dry cloth and it soaps up. This is great for after going out because it's simple and quick. You could just use it right in your room. Don't sleep in your makeup. I will say it again, don't sleep in your makeup. Your face will feel like death the next day. Your eyes will itch. Don't sleep in your contacts either. Both bad things to do. So there you have my main college essentials, subject to your own taste and flair. Join me next time. I'm going to be doing an at-home spa day episode, showing you how to do a whole day of pampering at home for a fraction of the cost of going to a spa. So that one might come in handy for you guys around midterms time, so stay tuned. Just because back to school is kind of a drag, that doesn't mean that all the fun parts of school don't come with it. And new fashion, fall trends, and making your room as cute as possible, all the social interaction, all the new experiences with college that come with it are all super fun and good things to look forward to, aside from the whole little school part. So I wish you guys the best of luck as you go off to school, whether you're a freshman. This is, you know, you trying to map out your way for the first time and get some tips, hopefully, about some essentials that you're going to want to have. Or I know all through my time there, I've constantly learned new ways to organize myself better, new ways to store more things in less space, and just be inventive with getting used to living in probably smaller quarters than you're used to. So wish you guys good luck. Enjoy the rest of your summer, though, and join me in my next episode. And Chelsea's going to make so much fun of me for this slide.